I welcome you all to our channel Let's Learn Automation, and in this session we are going to discuss one of the important topics like the interview tips, which are important and which needs to be taken care whenever we are going or attend the interview. So this is completely theoretical session, and we're going to discuss how we need to proceed to the interview. So basically what happened, in a Naukri we create our profile. After creating profile, we apply for many jobs, whatever the mail we are receiving on our mail ID or on our Naukri mailboxes. And after that, we are getting some mail, like mail from the recruiter that we have the JD like this, or we are looking for the candidate like this, and we need to reply them. So after replying, they are going to scrutinize our profile. And if also our profile is suitable for the particular post, then they are going to contact us. After contacting, they are going to check like what the tools we are going to used, we can say that, and the many more things by the HR. Then after, if the HR is satisfied with the candidate or with that call, then that HR is going to schedule an interview call. So after scheduling the interview call, we can say that if I am going to receive the call today, then the interview may be scheduled today itself, maybe tomorrow, maybe day after tomorrow, 2 day, 3 day later, we can say that, depending upon the panel availability. So what we need to do first, of all, we need to read the mail properly, like what the JD, the profile have, like which are the requirement, like if we are going for the manual testing and the JDs also require the manual testing, then our revision focus should be on a manual testing. If the profile is of automation tester, then our more focus is on the automation things. It is not like that we are going to revise only the automation things, or we are going to skip the manual one. But we need to prepare, or we need to revise all the things as per the JD, as per the job description, we can say that. So maybe that job description may contain the SQL things, or like we can say that the other programming language, like we can say that Unix or anything. So depending upon that, we need to proceed our revision, and we need to prepare for that. Now I collect some of the important tips for this particular process. So let's discuss on that. So here are some important interview tips. So basically, first of all, we'll discuss the prerequisite. What is the first of all requirement from our side, we can say that. So like first of all, we should have the good bandwidth or the internet connection with our laptop, because we are going to attend the interview or deliver the interview from the laptop itself. So good bandwidth should be required, because we need to present. Also we need to our camera should be on, so that require more bandwidth or good internet connection. So the first requisite, like we can say that we should have the good bandwidth. Then we need to check our camera and headphones are working or not. Then for interview process, we required some application, like we can say that Teams, Zoom or Skype, or we can say that even some type Eclipse also, to run the program or to showcase our knowledge in terms of programming. So we should have Teams, Zoom and Skype install on our laptop, we can say that. So it is also mentioned in our JD that which kind of call they are going to proceed, and are we going to add in the Zoom call or Teams call or any type of call. So this application should be there, because whenever you are going to join the interview, at that time it requires sufficient time, 2 to 3 minute time, to download that particular application, install, and maybe if the bandwidth is not good, then definitely that will create many problems. So our laptop should have the application like this. Then we should also comfortable with all these applications like Teams, Zoom, Skype. Comfortable mean to say that we should able to mute the call, we should able to unmute the call, then how to turn on the video, how to turn off the video, how to share the screen, and even how to chat, means where the chat section is available. Because sometimes it happens that interviewer may ask you that write down the code for this particular thing in a chat window itself. So we should confident about using the Teams and this application, we can say that. Then also we need to check our background, like whenever we are going to attend the interview call, at that time which background the interview will look for, or we can use the filter also, no problem, but also we need to take care about our background too, that should be plain enough. Then whenever we are going to start our camera, how we are look into the particular camera, like we can say that like our complete view is available in that camera, or the interviewer is able to see or not, like that we need to change or set an angle. Then as we are giving the interview or we are doing the interview, so at that time we should be in a good attire, like we can say that like if we are boy, girl, anything depending upon their gender, we can say that the attire should be good. Like we can say that if we are going to consider the male at that time, then there should be in a proper shirt or plain shirt, we can say that. So we should be in a good attire. Then our mobile should be on a silent mode. Many times it happened that at the time of interview it ring, or that may happen or may not. So these are the some we can say the little thing, but that is important too. And also we need to sit with the pen and paper. It is not like that interviewer will ask you that you need to draw this diagram on pen or paper, on paper we can say that, and then showcase in front of camera. But if we are missing any interview question, like if we are not able to answer, then we should know, or maybe after some time it happened that after interview we will not able to remind or will not able to remember what question we miss or what type of question we are not able to answer. So whenever we think that this question is not answerable by us, so we should note down that, by which we can improve that thing in the next interview, or we can search the solution for that particular question. So we should note down that question. So that's why we should have the pen and paper. Then every time, whenever the interview is going to start, we need to join the call before 5 to 10 minutes with the camera off, because the interviewer will join the call on the same time or 2 to 3 minutes after that. So we every time we should join the call before 5 to 10 minutes and with the camera off, because it is not like that we are going to we join the call before 10 minutes and we are just sitting in front of camera and just waiting for the interviewer. So it looks weird, or we can say that maybe it may happen that until the interviewer going to join the call, we may access the mobile, so that's not good at the time of interview. So we should have the camera off, and we need to wait until the interviewer or the panel will join. So these are the some prerequisites we should follow before the interview. Then let's discuss about the during the interview what we need to do. So whenever after starting the interview, when someone joins, like we come to know that there is one person is join, or the there is a notification, or we can see the that person is joined. So at that time we should turn on our camera and greet that person. Like if we are in the morning, afternoon or evening, so like good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, how are you, like that. So we need to start the conversation. Now after that, if that person is waiting for someone else to join, okay, so at that time it is not like that we will just sit idle and just waiting for other person to join. So we can start the conversation, okay, like we can ask that interviewer that how are you, where are you from, are you working from home or office, like that. So conversation should start, because it gives some confidence. Otherwise, if we start the conversation at the time of interview, then definitely we will be in a pressure that what type of question will cast, are we able to answer or not. So that may happen. So we should start the conversation before the interview itself, by which we will be relaxed. Then when someone else is joined the call, definitely we need to greet them too, okay, like again in the same way, like depending upon the time we have or the interview call. Then the first question will be like, we can say that introduce yourself or tell me something about yourself. Okay, so in that particular question, while this is our question, why our question? Because we are going to tell about ourselves. No one is going to interfere or no one is going to doubt upon you that what the thing you are telling in that particular answer. So in this particular question, we need to discuss about, or we need to inform or tell the interviewer about our education or qualification. then what experience we have, what type of experience we have, like manual automation, then in which domain we have work, okay, like security, then multimedia or education or anything, and which type of tools we use for manual automation or anything. So these are things which we can discuss in a first question. Then the one more important thing we should understand that whenever interview is going to ask anything, so it is not like that if we know the answer of any question, so we should directly jump to the question. So basically, first listen the question carefully and give some time to ourselves, like to just think about the to just think like how we are going to start the answer of that question. It should not be do like that, like we have started the answer of the question, then we come to know that, oh no, that's not the right way, I need to start from here. So after listening the question, we should give some time to ourselves, and then we need to proceed with the answer. So mean to say that we don't need to rush for the answer. Then one more important thing, like treat the interview like a conversation. Like whenever interview is going on, so that is what the discussion with the candidate, the company is looking for. It is not like the viva in a college that someone is going to ask the question and you are going to answer. This is what the kind of discussion. So we should treat that discussion like a discussion itself. Otherwise, it will be viva voice. Like what is inheritance? What is like constructor? What is this keyword? What is super keyword? So we should treat the interview like a conversation, or the we can say that the discussion. Then whenever we are going to answer any question, so if the question is like technical, then we need to adopt some technique. The technique is like, if someone is asked about any technical thing, then we need to relate that particular thing with the project, whatever the project on which we have we already worked. So for example, here I use the example of constructor. So if someone asks you about the constructor, then first of all, we need to tell the definition about the constructor. So what is the constructor? Like constructor is a special member function, then its name is same as the class name and blah, 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 everything. Okay. And then we need to tell them that where we use the constructor in our project, and try to adopt this thing with the every question we have from the interviewer, by which interviewer will come to know that, yes, these are the things which we know, and these things we used in our project. So that gives a better perspective about us. Then it may be happen that like an next point we can say that maybe we don't know the answer of that question, but it is not like that we are going to deny that question. No, we don't know the answer of this question. No, not like that. We need to try, because in an interview or in any process, we can say that we are the problem solver or we are the troubleshooter. So we need to attempt the every question. Doesn't matter are we going to complete the answer of that question or not, but we need to attempt. So it is not like that we are going to say, I don't know the answer, can we jump to the next question. So for example, if interviewers are told us that can you write down the program for a particular scenario, then if we already done that thing, then it's okay. But for example, if we haven't aware about the logic of that program, then we need to try to develop the logic on the same time. Okay, if we are able to do that, then that's a great thing. But if we are not able to do that, then it's okay, because we are trying at least. So we should attempt the question with a positive attitude, that the interviewer come to know that, yes, he have no idea about this particular thing, but he is trying to attempt that question. Maybe that may be wrong or right, but attempt is a positive thing, we can say that. And for anything, our attitude should be positive and the learning. Like if you are not able to answer any question, then we need to attempt. Okay. And then also, if you are not able to do that, then it's okay that we can go for the next question. And also, for example, if you know some language like Java, .NET or anything, and the interviewer is saying that we need the candidate for the Python, then we can directly say that, as I know Java, I will also learn the Python too in the same way, because Java is a, we can say that, a tougher language as compared to Python, because Python is a new generation language that is more easier than the Java. So definitely we can learn, we already know the Java, so we can learn the Python. So this is what the learning attitude. So in every interview, if we are not aware about the technology or the tools or the language which is used by the company or the interviewer, then we should have the attitude like we can learn those things. So that gives the good impact. Then at the end of interview, there may be a question like what we need to ask. That interviewer will ask you like, do you have any question? So this is the common question which is asked by any all the interviewers. So many have the doubt like what should we ask? Is it good to ask the question to the interviewer itself? No. So the answer is like there is no problem, because if we have some doubt in our mind, then definitely we should ask it. So at the end of interviewer, if he is going to ask that like, do you have any doubt, any question? So definitely we can ask the question like, which type of profile we are looking for, you are looking for for which domain, and how many percentage manual testing you are going to perform, and what is the percentage automation, and is the project is ongoing or a new project, we can say that, or anything. We don't need to ask for the feedback, because if the interviewer wants to give the feedback, then definitely he will give that feedback. But it's a very wrong habit to ask about the feedback in interview itself, because if you ask like that, then interview will say that HR will share the feedback with you, because most of the time interviewer is not going to share the feedback about your interview. So this is the wrong question. But we can ask the question like, what kind of domain we are working, project we are working, then we can say that what type of automation tool you use. So these are the some question we can ask, and any question which relate with the our we can say that profile we can ask. And at last also we need to greet that particular interviewer or the panel like, nice to talk to you, thank you for your time, because the panel is working in a company and they are just putting some time aside for interview process. So that's why their time is also important, as we our time is also important. So in the same way, they are also sharing their time with us. So that's why we need to greet them. We can greet them like, nice to talk to you and thank you for your time, have a good day. And if there is any festival or occasion is coming or ongoing, or we can say that coming after some days, then definitely we can say like that, if we are going to deliver the interview in December, then we can say that Happy New Year in advance or anything. So these are some interview points, or we can say that some tricks we need to use while delivering the interview. And remember one thing, so this is the complete process of interview, like prerequisite and during the interview what we need to do, even after the interview what we need to do. And after that we will wait for the interview, HR feedback. So if we got the feedback from HR in 1 to 3 days, then it's okay, no problem. But if we think that our interview is quite good and definitely we should receive the feedback for the second round or for the next round, then we should contact to HR, or we need to take the follow from the HR that what is the next process, or what is the feedback from the interviewer. And remember one thing, that interviewer is giving the feedback on the same day, or even we can say that on the same time interview is going to finish. The interviewer is not going to do like that on the day one, on 1st of Jan we can say that interview is done, and after 2 days he is going to share the feedback, because until that maybe interviewer will forget about the feedback of a particular candidate. So at the same time, every time, even whenever I am going to take the interview, at the same time I need to deliver the feedback too. So remember one thing, maybe HR will say that we haven't received the feedback from the interviewer, but this is never going to happen with anyone. Interviewer share the feedback on the same time interview is going to end, or on the same day we can say that at max. So if it is a positive feedback, then definitely you will get the call. But maybe sometime HR may forget about you, that he need to call you or need to tell about you, because it happened with me also. HR forget to inform me about the process. So we need to take the follow-up. After 1 to 3 days, if you are not getting any response from the HR, then we need to contact him by mail, or if you have the contact number, from the contact number that what is the feedback. So these are the some important topic which are really important, like for the, we can say that fresher, even for the experienced candidate too. So we need to take care about all those things. So thank you.